Today I ask the question, is it better to stack or to track in astrophotography? Recently, I've had the opportunity to use a star tracker in astrophotography, so I thought it would be good to see what was better, stacking or tracking. They are both legitimate ways of shooting the stars, and they're both quite advanced techniques. If you're not sure how to shoot the stars, but you want to learn more, the best thing is to start taking single images of night skies. Stacking is a process of taking a series of shots, including things called dark frames, and then putting them into a dedicated piece of software that stacks them together and reduces the noise in the image. Whereas tracking is where you put your camera on a specific gadget and it follows the movement of the stars, cancelling out the rotation of the Earth. When set up properly, you can have exposure times of up to 10 minutes, and this means you can drop your ISO and play around with your aperture. To capture some images that you will stack later, all you need is your camera, a tripod, and a good lens. The software that you use to stack your images is a lot cheaper than a tracker. On a Mac, if you're using Starry Landscape Stacker, it's just under $40. If you're on a PC, you can use Sequiter, which is a free piece of software. As you only have to set up your camera and tripod, all you need to do is compose the frame and then take the sequence of shots. So the setup time is a lot quicker than if you're tracking the stars. Another advantage with stacking the shots is it gets rid of all of that noise automatically, including the long exposure noise. When stacking images, you can also shoot a time lapse. So this means you don't just get one use out of a single image, you'll get lots of different uses. So the main advantage with stacking is you can take a shot, and then you can move your camera, frame up something different, and then take that shot. So throughout the course of the night, you'll end up with a lot more images when stacking shots. It does take quite a lot of time to stack the images together. I stack TIFF files and I've got quite a fast computer, but sometimes I just have to leave it to process the images. If you are processing them on a Mac, the software is $39.99. So you do have to invest a little bit of money in the software, but I think it's well worth it. I've left some links in the description below to both Sequiter for the PC and Starry Landscape Stacker for the Mac. Moving on to tracking, this is a very different way to shoot the stars. I've only started it this year, and one of my good friends, Arun, lent me his spare tracker. It's a really good system, and you can take some really good images with it. Arun is into deep space astrophotography, and he's got some amazing images, so I'd suggest heading over to his Instagram page and checking out the images that he's taken. The first advantage to tracking that I noticed straight away is that you get so many more colors in your Milky Way, and you can see them on the back of your camera. As you're shooting with longer exposures, this means you can really drop your ISO down and really soak up those deep colors in the Milky Way. Also, with the longer exposures, you can play around with your aperture. So if you close your aperture down quite a bit, you'll be able to make the stars burst a little bit. If I zoom in on this image, you can see Jupiter has those starbursts coming out of it. You do get to buy more kit. So if you're a gearhead and you love going out and getting new bits of equipment, this is the perfect excuse. As it's a completely different way of shooting the stars, it can be really fun learning this new process. As you can shoot with much longer exposure times, this opens up the opportunity not only to get really wide field shots, but to get close-ups of different parts of the night sky. And if you really get into it, you can get much longer focal lengths and start picking out nebulas, planets, and things like that. One of the main advantages I see of using a tracker is that you don't actually need really fast lenses. I've tracked a few shots between f4 and f8 and got some really good looking images. So with a kit lens, you have the opportunity to shoot the stars without getting lots of noise in your night skies. It does take quite a while to set up, and you will need to see the North Star, which is Polaris. Obviously, you will have to invest in a tracker, so there is a bit of an investment to tracking the stars. You will have to learn a new skill, and this is getting your polar alignment correct. If you don't, you'll find that you won't be able to get much longer exposures than normal. So do some research and find out how to line up your tracker perfectly, and then you can get 4, 8 and maybe 10 minute exposures. As well as buying the tracker, you will have to invest in a sturdy tripod. I've got an old video tripod that I use with it and it works really well. But if you have a small tripod for your mirrorless camera, you may have to invest in a bigger, stronger, more sturdy tripod. If you do end up shooting exposures between 8 and 10 minutes, you will be waiting around for that exposure time to finish. If you do have the foreground in the shot, while it's tracking the stars over those minutes of exposure, it will blur the foreground out. So you will have to blend at least two images together to get a clean foreground. If you live in a hot country, with these long exposures, you'll get long exposure noise. Now you can either turn on long exposure noise reduction or take a dark frame. And both of these take the same amount of time as it would to take the initial exposure. So both of them take a long time, especially with these really long exposures. There are other ways to get rid of long exposure noise. If you're not sure how to do this but want to learn more, click on the eye in the corner or the link in the description. This will take you to another of my tutorials. So you can see there are both advantages and disadvantages to stacking and tracking. Up until recently, I've only shot single images of the stars, but after using a tracker and actually after having a go at stacking, this has really opened up what I can do and what I'm gonna do in the future. Looking at the images, tracking gives a really clear image, and with the lower ISO levels, it really brings out the colors in the Milky Way as well as the nebulas. With stacking, you don't seem to get the same amount of detail in the sky and the Milky Way as a tracked image, but you do get rid of the long exposure noise. Also, when you have a foreground in the shot, it's much cleaner and there's a lot less noise in it. Therefore, you can bring up the brightness a lot more and really bring out the details in the foreground, especially when it's really dark. The one main disadvantage with tracking is that once it's set up, you can take shots and you can move the camera around, but if you go to move the tripod to a different location, you have to set up the polar alignment once again. And that's about it. I think what I'm going to do in the future is track the sky so I get those really rich, deep colors in the Milky Way. And then what I'll do is I'll stack the foreground. So I'll turn the tracker off and then take a series of images for the foreground. I was pleasantly surprised at how stacking the images really reduces the noise in the foreground. If I'm in a bit of a rush, I'll probably just stack my images. But what this process has taught me is that tracking and stacking your images is the next step to astrophotography. If this has piqued your interest for a tracker or astrophotography, check out the list of equipment I have in the description below. They are affiliate links, so if you do decide to buy your equipment through these links, I'll get a little bit of money with no extra expense to you. And this really helps me keep this channel going. If you don't have the funds or access to a tracker, I'd suggest starting to stack your astrophotography shots. As well as getting a time lapse, you'll be able to get a much cleaner single image for your portfolio. And if you stack and/or track your shots, let me know in the description below how you've got on. It'll be interesting to hear your thoughts on both of these different processes. As always, if you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And for weekly tutorials, hints and tips in photography and videography, subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll see you next time.